determine percentage of carbon and percentage of hydrogen by which is nothing but also called as an ultimate analysis. Today we are going to find out percentage of nitrogen, and it can be determined by very famous method called Jenda's method. Very famous method. This method is used to find out percentage of nitrogen which is present in the given sample of the coal than in the given sample of the fuel. Let's see what are the steps and how this Jenda's method is used to find out percentage of nitrogen. The very first step is take the weight of the coal. So coal may take the weight of the fuel, from which weight we are going to find out the percentage of nitrogen. Let's say the weight has come double gram, 5 gram, 10 gram, or we will say double gram. After taking the weight of the coal, now you take one long neck glass called Jenda's glass. In that glass, you take your coal sample or your perfume, and in that you add concentrated sulfuric acid plus potassium sulfate. So now Jenda's glass contains coal sample, concentrated sulfuric acid, and potassium sulfate. All these three together. Now it is heated. Before heating, you just close it and then heat this sample. When you heat it, how long this will take till you get clear solution? When you get clear solution in the Jenda's glass, formation of clear solution indicates the formation of ammonium sulfate. If you get a clear solution in the Jenda's glass, that means that there is a formation of ammonium sulfate. It means that the nitrogen which was there in the coal react with concentrated sulfuric acid in the presence of potassium sulfate, and it is converted to ammonium sulfate. After this, the content of Jenda's glass is transferred into the round bottom glass. In the round bottom glass, there is already sodium hydroxide is there, and now the content of the Jenda's glass, which is nothing but ammonium sulfate. So this ammonium sulfate is transferred in the round bottom glass, which already contains sodium hydroxide, and this round bottom glass is heated with a relay grate. One end is kept in the round bottom glass, and another end of the relay grate is immersed in or deep in the known volume of standard solution of an acid. So when you heat this round bottom glass, which contains sodium hydroxide and ammonium sulfate, there is a reaction between ammonium sulfate and sodium hydroxide which leads to the release of ammonia. So how this ammonia is formed? Look at here, the ammonium sulfate from Jenda's glass, when it is reacted with sodium hydroxide, two molecules which is there in the round bottom glass, this will lead to the formation of first sodium sulfate, Na2SO4, and there are two ammonium groups are there. From each ammonium, just remove one hydrogen. From second ammonium, second hydrogen. So NH4 में से एक H चला गया, NH3. Then from second ammonium में से एक H चला गया, NH3. Means two moles of ammonia, and 2H from here and 2H from here will give twice H2O. These are the products which are formed in the raw process. But most important product is ammonia. The ammonia which is released due to the reaction between sodium hydroxide and ammonium sulfate is allowed to pass through the derivative. And when it will pass through the derivative, and then it will absorb in the known volume of standard acids. So ammonia will react with acid and will form ammonium chloride. So you might notice in the entire experiment, the nitrogen of the coal first of all converted to ammonium sulfate. Then ammonium sulfate from nitrogen or from ammonium sulfate is converted to ammonia. Now from ammonia we can find out how much amount of nitrogen. अब इस अमोनियम में से आपको पता करना है कितना नाइट्रोजन. तो अमोनिया इज अ बेस, एंड अ बेस विच इज अमोनिया विच इज अ बेस इज एब्जॉर्ब बाय एन एसिड. तो कितना एसिड न्यूट्रलाइज हुआ है बाय द अमोनिया. How much acid is neutralized by the liberated ammonia? From that you will get amount of ammonia. एंड फ्रॉम अमाउंट ऑफ मुझे पे अमाउंट ऑफ मैंडेट। तो अब मुझे पता करना कितना एलसी यूटिलाइज हुआ है, तो कितना एसिड यूटिलाइज हुआ है ये पता करने के बजाय आप पता करो कितना एसिड अर्न रिएक्ट। अब सपोज मान के चलो इसमें 100 मॉलिक्यूल्स एसीएल थे, 100 मॉलिक्यूल्स सपोज में से मान के चलो 25 एसीएल यूटिलाइज हो गए, 25 एसीएल यूटिलाइज हुए इसका मतलब 25 अमोनिया फॉर्म हुई। बट आई डोंट नो हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड इज यूटिलाइज, बट आई कैन फाइंड आउट हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड अनरिएक्टेड। फ्रॉम अनरिएक्टेड यू कैन फाइंड आउट हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड रिएक्टेड, एंड फ्रॉम अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड रिएक्टेड इज अमाउंट ऑफ अमोनिया फॉर्म। तो अगर आपको पता करना है कितना एसिड अनरिएक्टेड है, तो यू टाइट्रेट डिसोल्यूशन विद ए स्टैंडर्ड सोल्यूशन ऑफ बेस। व्हेन यू टाइट्रेट दिस मिक्सचर विद ए स्टैंडर्ड सोल्यूशन ऑफ बेस you will get amount of unreacted acid. Amount of unreacted acid. Unreacted means amount of acid consumed by liberated ammonia. अगर आपको पता चला कितना unreacted है तो इसका मतलब कितना reacted है, जितना reacted है इसका मतलब कितना ammonia form है। And once you know the amount of ammonia, you can get amount of nitrogen. Let's see how. So once we get all these things, now simple equation. Let's transform this observation into a formula, and the formula will lead to the calculation. Look at here the reaction first of all. The NH3 was absorbed by ammonia. Ammonia is absorbed in HCl, and we know ammonium chloride. This was the reaction taking place in the last class. देखिए वन अमोनिया को वन HCl एंड फ्रॉम अमोनिया कैन फाइंड आउट नाइट्रोजन। लुक एट द सिंपल इक्वेशन 1000 mL वन नॉर्मल HCl टू वन नॉर्मल अमोनिया। ठीक है, एक HCl को एक अमोनिया, अमाउंट ऑफ अमोनिया इज डिटरमाइंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड। तो 1000 mL वन नॉर्मल HCl इज वन नॉर्मल अमोनिया, वन HCl वन अमोनिया, वन नॉर्मल HCl वन अमोनिया। One of the ammonia is, what is the molecular weight ammonia? Molecular weight ammonia, ammonia molecular weight is 14 plus 3 means 70. और 17 में कितना ammonia है? कितना nitrogen है? 14. तो now write 1000 mL. One normal HCl is one ammonia right? 14 gram of nitrogen. Is so writing one ammonia, I write 14 gram of nitrogen, because one ammonia means one ammonia contains 14 gram of nitrogen. So this is a standard equation. 1000 mL, one normal HCl equal 14 gram of nitrogen. But how much amount of acid is consumed? Let's say x mL. Itna acid consumed hua tha. ये कैसे पता चला कितना एसिड कंज्यूम कर, ये तो अमाउंट ऑफ एसिड कंज्यूम इज डिटरमाइंड इन द एज कंज्यूम इज डिटरमाइंड बाय टाइट्रेटिंग वर्सेस स्टैंडर्ड सॉल्यूशन ऑफ बेस। कितना एसिड अनरिएक्टेड था, अनरिएक्टेड एसिड से पता चला कितना एसिड रिएक्ट हुआ मींस कंज्यूम हुआ, एंड देन दैट रीडिंग इज x ml एंड द नॉर्मलिटी ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन नॉर्मलिटी ऑफ एसिड वाज 0.1 नॉर्मल HCl, x ml 0.1 नॉर्मल एसिड इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच द अमाउंट क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई x into 0.1 into 14 divided by 1000 gram of nitrogen. This much gram of nitrogen. देखिए 1000 ml one normal HCl is 14 gram. इतना ml of acid consumed हुआ था by the liberated ammonia. And the normality of acid was 0.1 normal. So x ml of acid consumed by the liberated ammonia of 0.1 normal HCl correspond to how much gram of nitrogen? So x multiply 0.1, multiply 14 and divide by 1000. This much gram of hydrogen, but it is in how much? W gram of coal. इतने coal में इतना nitrogen है, लेकिन मुझे इतने gram coal में नहीं चाहिए, मुझे 100 gram अगर coal लूंगा, 100 gram coal के अंदर how much gram of nitrogen? Cross multiply. X multiply 0.1, multiply 14, multiply by 100 again. X multiply 0.1, multiply 14, multiply by 100, divided by 1000 into W. This is nothing but percentage of nitrogen. Let's simplify the formula. 20 cancel. Now this 14 by 10 is 1 by 4, 1 by 4, I will take x into 0.1 into 1.4 divided by the blue. This is nothing but percentage of nitrogen present in the fuel. Look at here. This is the second, the next formula, x into 0.1 into 1.4 divided by the blue. In this formula, again we need to do only two things, x and W. You know what is x? Amount of acid consumed by liquid ammonia. And you know what is W? Weight of the boat. Agar aapke paas ye do value hai, kitna acid consumed hua by the liquid ammonia or weight of the coal. We know what is this 0.1, this is nothing but normality of the acid into 1.4 divided by W, that will give percentage of nitrogen. Instead of this, you can write percentage of nitrogen also include x. I will write volume of acid consumed into normality of acid into 1.4 divided by W. Kitna acid consume into what is the normality of acid? It may be 1.5, it may be 0.1, it may be 0.5, it may be 0.2 into 1.4. The 1.4 after 1.4 and divided by W, that will give percentage of nitrogen. See, two values aapko chahiye. Volume of acid consumed by liquid ammonia and weight of the coal. This brings normality of acid is constant, 1.4 is constant, and weight of the coal is remaining. So, knowing these two values, you can get percentage of nitrogen, and that is nothing but Jenner's method. So, till now, we have determined percentage of carbon, percentage of hydrogen, and now percentage of nitrogen. In this also, we need to know only two things. Two values we need to know. Here also, we need to know two values. Here also we need to know only two values. Two values means one is x and second is w. X, the volume of acid consumed. W, the weight of the coal taken. Knowing these two values, we can get percentage of hydrogen. Knowing these two values, we can get percentage of hydrogen. Knowing the two values, we can get percentage of carbon. This is nothing but an ultimate analysis.